Much like how humans transmit the common cold, by inhaling infected respiratory droplets or direct contact with saliva, nasal discharge, or tears.
We always recommend for pet owners that they don't leave food outside for long periods of time. Ideally, if you have an animal that's outside, then feed it a meal that it eats right away so that bowl is empty, and then wash and clean that bowl and store it inside the house.
The larger concern for canine distemper, though, is its potential to spread among dense wildlife populations like raccoons, possums, and foxes.
For the most part, it's not a curable condition. You just treat the symptoms the best you can, and sometimes animals recover from it, usually with sort of persistent chronic neurologic signs, or they die.
The Department of Fish and Wildlife suggests to remove food and anything else that might attract wild animals. Distemper can cause respiratory, neurological, and gastrointestinal illness. What dog owners should be looking for from their pets?
Lethargy, maybe the head's down, the ears are sort of flat, they're not up, they're not what we call bright, alert, and responsive. They seem depressed, they're sort of listless.
Puppies and dogs who have not been vaccinated are the most vulnerable to the potentially fatal disease. And wildlife officials were quick to point out that just as wild animals can spread distemper to domestic dogs, an unvaccinated pet can also spread the virus to wildlife.
Our goal is to minimize transmission both ways and take pets out of that disease cycle. Protect pets, because if you vaccinate pets, you're also protecting wildlife.
Now, usually distemper